Hello, my friends. Welcome to Trading with KS. So today is 22nd of November 2021. So today is the first trading day after the Malacca election. Let's see how the market is doing. Today got some, quite a few news to talk about. We got news about pharma. We got news about PIE, In Nature, and also Bintai, you know. Okay, let's check out the introduction first. Disclaimer, be advised that I'm not a professional trader or advisor. I am sharing my trading journey for entertainment purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, price, or other information contained in this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including without limitation to any loss of profit, money, asset, or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video. Trading foreign exchange indexes, stock market, futures, commodities, energy, precious metal, etc. carry a high level of risk, and please trade on your own research and assessment. Please seek advice from a professional financial advisor for your trading needs. Okay, let's check out the big picture first. Let's check out the market. Let me refresh first, make sure the new data. Okay, so KLSE today up 0.087%, 1.3 points. Nothing much. Singapore up 0.147%, Hong Kong down 0.39%, South Korea up 1.4%, not bad. Japan up 0.095%, little bit. China, FTSE up 0.19%, SSE up 0.61%, ZSE up 1.4%. So China, a small rebound, getting slight rebound. Australia dropped 0.58, New Zealand dropped 1.0, Taiwan dropped 0.083. So not very strong. Asia today also not very strong. But still not bad. Still not bad. Quite good. Actually quite good. But not very strong. But not bad. Okay, let's look at Europe. FTSE UK up 0.3%, DAX up 0.044 little bit. So UK is doing slightly better okay, from the last few weeks. But today India dropped quite a lot, 1.9. Okay, so Asia okay lah, but not too bad lah. India Nifty dropped a lot. Today Dow Jones dropped 0.75 on NYSE. NYSE dropped 0.84. That's why India dropped so much. S&P dropped 0.14. Nasdaq still up 0.399. Nasdaq is going up and up and up non-stop. Very very strong. Okay, so crude palm oil very strong, 5,004. Okay, I think the first time we reached 5,004. I think this whole year, right? Okay, so there is a possibility that we want to see metal. Remember last week we talked about the big picture, right? Saturday, Sunday we talk a big picture. We want to see one eye, want to see metal. Maybe one eye want to see palm oil, Okay, Brent oil 79, crude oil 76. So oil is really dropping, So oil counters best not to hold, Gold also drop a lot. Correction, 18.1839. So still above 1008, still we consider bullish. Silver also dropped a bit, 2,2478. Okay, so the big winner is still palm oil, going up and up and up and up. Okay, check out KLSE. So KLSE nothing, KLSE just okay, no direction. Okay, no direction. We got a pin bar. All these are very small candle, no direction candle. You can say almost all these candle now is no direction. Waiting for big direction, but still no direction yet. All the not bullish, not bearish. All is dodgy candle. Okay, dodgy candle. Okay, so we are waiting for our chart to show direction. We got this channel over here. Okay, so you want to wait for big push above. Then there is a short window. Okay, to go to 1546 and see what happened here. Breakthrough, fantastic. Cannot go through means this sideways or downtrend will persist. Okay, or if we drop below, then we have to wait for a rebound, maybe around 1.1495 if we drop below the channel. Okay, sentiment is of course negative, RSI below 50. Check out Busa. I'm not sure whether this volume correct or not. 2.45 billion. I think this is the smallest we have seen for this whole year. I think probably one of the smallest or the smallest. So market no confidence at all. okay, institution are not firing the bullet, because 2.415 billion volume let me double check wait. Okay, I try to check another website. The other website didn't report the volume so I assume this one is correct lah. 2.45451 so very small volume extremely small okay. So today consumer down 0.31, industry up 0.36, construction up 0.47, technology up 0.11, finance up 0.37, property down 0.12, plantation today strongest 1.22, REIT drop 0.36, energy definitely drop 2.2, healthcare drop 0.36, telecommunication up 0.04, transportation I think no good. Transportation, I think didn't rebound from the bottom channel, so I think transportation out already. I think plantation now is strong. Utilities up down 0.39, so transportation not good, okay. So today I got post a few things. So for you guys, don't forget check out my weekly Saturday Sunday video. Important Saturday we talk about big picture, the global indexes, the oil price, steel price, and also the local index. You know, and Sunday we review all the stock that we talk about one whole week. So we want to see how it goes. You know, how's the development of the stock? So morning KLCI already quite weak. Okay, morning already sentiment 45. Okay, up 3 points. So evening even worse. The strongest is plantation. Morning strongest is plantation. Also, we talk about KSM. Okay, big push today. B plant also got push up. MMSV at the bottom channel. Okay, so later we take a look. Okay, when you guys want to buy me coffee, don't forget go to ko-fi.com. Trading with KS. Okay, you also can follow me here. Okay, because I also do a lot of posts over here nowadays. Okay, look at PIE. Okay, PIE third quarter profit dip 1% to 12 million amid 6% rise in revenue. So their revenue is up only net profit drop to 240 last time now it's 227 drop 6%. Net profit dip 1%. Okay, net profit is 11.91 million. Okay, last year was 12.03, but revenue up still not bad revenue is up still not bad. Okay, because looks like their business is doing well okay, so let's take a quick look at PIE. PIE really hit target already. We play from here. So this one wait for bottom channel, see what happened. If we rebound, maybe we can chase again. But this one already hit target Okay. Kenanga target 4.5 and our top channel. So we play here to here, here to here. We get around 14% So this one wait for it, wait whether it can rebound from the bottom channel. Okay, just wait and see. Okay, wait and see. If we can rebound, maybe can try chase again. If RSI go through 50. Maybe can try again Pin bar over here look like got support so watch out So if next few days okay, it can hang above here, I think it can go up. Possible it got chance to go up again. 3.86. Okay, I put alarm in. So it goes above 3.86, maybe can play one more time. Because semiconductor still strong So in nature not doing well their profit drop let me find the news Okay, so profit down 89% so not good okay, because of the COVID lockdown revenue also dropped 46% okay, so from 41 million to 32 million so no good. So we take a quick look in nature. In nature is Body Shop it's the mother company of Body Shop. So drop below channel already. So this one better don't play lah. Now at the bottom channel, maybe can rebound lah. But based on such a poor report, I think better don't play lah. I think it will probably continue to drop more. Oh, so this one already finished play already lah. In nature, most likely it will finish. KSM. Okay, KESM, they reported net profit up 8.83 times okay, to 7.5 million 7.517 million, and also their turnover also went up 12% turnover also. This one don't have the English version, so this one the revenue, okay, the turnover, okay, also went up to 68 million, okay, for the first quarter, so they are doing very well, they're doing EMS, so KESM, this is the first quarter, their profit also go up 8 times, and their revenue, turnover also go up 12%, okay, so KESM is reporting very good numbers, so we take a look at KESM, KSM went up here. I think KSM, right? Possible 15, 17. I think KSM is a channel. KSM is a. So today, alarm went off. I went in to see here. Okay. When I saw it, the price was up around 5%. So after lunchtime, when I want to do the posting that time, it already went up to 11, 10% already. So this one can chase or not? I think probably can chase. So tomorrow maybe see if tomorrow got drop or not. If drop better, okay. If no drop also maybe can play some lah. But now economy is very bad, okay, the market very bad, play some coffee money only, okay lah. Don't expect to hit big jackpot, it's very difficult lah. Okay. So this one, if tomorrow it drop a little bit better, buy cheap lah. Maybe you put some limit order, you know, cheaper to 13.8, you know. Hopefully 13 or 14 or at 14 14 ringgit, okay, pick some limit order, maybe can come down, pick some cheap one, okay, maybe tomorrow morning got you know lah, people take profit, so maybe you can catch some cheap one, so possible hold it to 15 or even 17.3 lah. I would possible look at here 17.3, okay, looking at their data, right, their result, their report is very good, okay, looks like they are will be doing well lah. So stop loss will be 11.93 lah, but if it drop below 13.48, cannot hold above 13.48, you want to cut also can, because economy no good, don't hold too many stock lah, not economy, market no good lah. So Asia going back to Singapore lah, so good for them lah. So Sinovac can further boost Pharma Niaga sales lah. So this one is talking about Pharma Niaga because of the booster shot, right? So now they got chance to go higher lah, but this one, right? But this Kenanga give their TP at 0.85, okay, give their TP at 0.85, so nothing much to talk about lah. So there's another story about Pharma, wait lah. Okay, also this one CIMB also cut Pharma Niaga TP, okay, because they don't see their, you know, to taper earning, to taper off lah, means at the end their earning will slow down lah, because of the end of the COVID lah. So only they said that this Sinovac booster shot may give them some boost lah, temporary boost in their profit lah, but long term they don't think it is very very good lah. So they are putting target price from trim the target price from 1.06 to 1 lah. Okay, so we got two news here about this pharma. So we take a quick look at pharma. Okay, so today drop back, okay. So Kenanga give here, okay. Kenanga give here, 0.85. So Kenanga give here 0.85. So Kenanga target already hit already, okay. Kenanga target already hit. So now CIMB target 1.0, Hong Leong Bank 1.0, 1.1, 1.04. Maybe, as I said, got chance to come to here. I said 0.95 and 1.0. This is as far as I go. I can see it can go. So now the bank also come in with these two targets. So this is almost like what we analyzed last few days, right? It's correct lah. Okay. So this will support what I talk about. I said here, okay, 0.95 and 1.0. That is short term because it's end of COVID. Not to say we confirm end but looking at the market, right? Looking of the development, right? COVID is going to we are near the end of the COVID infection so this one doesn't look like got a lot of chance to jump until one ringgit 30 cent like last time, you know. So maybe, okay, so this one you're holding this. If you haven't buy in, wait for it to go through 0.86 first, then you look at 1.0 at CMB price and Hong Leong Bank. If it cannot go through 0.865, then don't go in. Not enough momentum. Don't go in. So foreign investor, Malaysia stock net buyers. So foreign investor are still net buyers. Okay, 66 million. Okay, so B plant, they want to replant their plantation. 7% total oil palm plantation, accelerating replanting. This is just news. But today, B plant got some rebound. We take a look whether it's good or not. So B plant today not bad. Okay, B plant that day we talk about here, right? We talk about here. Okay, we talk about here 0.665. okay, if it can hold above 0.665, continue to hold. So this one we still continue to hold. So our target is 0.77 and 0.83. Okay, these are two targets. If it drop below 0.665 out, looks like it want to rebound. Okay, looks like they are reporting their earning, right? Soon. Okay, looks like their earning should be good. So there's one more goring here, maybe to 0.770 or unlikely 0.835 because so near already. So maybe can go to 0.770 lah. Look at 0.770 first. Okay. From that day, the breakout over here. From the day breakout over here, also got 10% lah. 10% take lah. Market so bad. So Kenanga upgrade Affin Bank to market perform. Market perform only lah. Not buy call lah. Market perform means okay lah. Not bad lah. Not below market expectation lah. So our target price is 1.55 lah. We take a quick look Affin lah. Affin Bank. And Affin Bank is in the downtrend channel lah. I haven't drawn the channel. Sorry. Let me draw the channel. So it's in the downtrend channel lah. Nothing much to talk about lah. So Nanga also give target over below our current price, so this one cannot play lah, nothing to play. So Hexstar posted Q net profit 7.21 million so it's a drop it's a decline from 12.47 million so not good for news for them. Revenue also increased, okay, marginal increase 1 million compared to last year so not too bad lah. Revenue got increased, net profit drop a bit. It's not a very very bad story lah. 12.47 million, 42% okay. Net profit normally okay. Product, I mean the cost, you know, management, operation cost, all those can affect this net profit lah. But very important is that revenue didn't drop lah. Means the business is still growing revenue is still going up by 1 million, so not that bad lah. Hexstar, take a look. Not that bad. Okay, still strong. You see their chart is still strong. Their uptrend is still healthy. Uptrend is still healthy. Now, Hexstar looks like want to rebound at here. A bit dangerous chasing here. Because it's the middle of the channel. I prefer it to come down to the bottom channel. I would prefer if you want to chase Hexstar, right? I would prefer it to come back to lower here. We now got a pin bar, maybe got another push up, but I will not chase. It doesn't meet my channel requirement. I prefer it to come back to the bottom channel around around 1 ringgit 30 31 cent around this area lah. Then only rebound, only I will chase lah. Because I don't want to chase in the middle channel. Nothing to chase. You chase really straight away, hit the wall already, hit the top of the channel. So nothing to play lah. You chase here straight away, 6%, you already hit the wall already. So I will wait for it to go down some more lah. Petronas Gas. So Petronas Gas, net profit down, revenue up a bit, profit down, net profit down 1.2, but revenue up 1.45%, so not bad, So we take a quick look at Petronas Gas. So Petronas Gas didn't break through didn't break out, so nothing to temporarily nothing to play for Petronas Gas, right? If you are looking for capital gain one, I mean you buy low sell high, then it better you look for it to break through 17 ringgit first, 17 ringgit, then only maybe you go for this capital gain. If you buy for long-term dividend, then okay lah. But capital gain, maybe you go through 7 ringgit, then you look for Hong Leong Bank. Hong Leong Bank give 19, or possible you can. But you see, they are not making big profit lah. So you can't see it to go very fast lah, because all these are marginal only, 1.45%, 1.2%, 1.72%. So Bintai gets to acquire Johnson Medical for 50 million. So they already swallow up Johnson Medical. See how's their stock doing. Bintai. Sideways, nothing much. I thought it still can rebound some more for you to run, for those who already get caught by high to run, but still nothing much. Wait and see lah. If it drop below here, then we really have to run. This is the last support. Have to run. If it drop below 0.33, then no choice, have to run. If it stay above 0.33, maybe still got chance to go back to 0.4, then run. So not really finished scoring already. All their story already here, scoring to 0.73, already finished scoring, I think. Okay, so Petronas Chemical third Q profit. This is good. More than 3-4 to 1.96 billion, 10 cent dividend from 14 net profit from 471 million to 1.96 billion. Okay, so their revenue also went up 3.5 billion to 5.8 billion. Okay, 67%. So Petronas Chemical making a ton of money, tons of money. Petronas Chemical, we got target. Maybank 9.7, so the price went up. I thought it can continue to go, but cannot. It come back down at stop loss here. Okay, 8.2 around stop loss here. Now nothing much, doing nothing much. If you already cut loss, forget about it. If you still holding it, still hold it. 8.25 is the final cut loss. Drop some more out. If it can go through, if you want to try again, this one go through 8.4, maybe can try. If it can go above 8.4 again, can try. Because seems like they're doing well lah, because of the chemical price, possible go up because of oil price go up lah. So chemical also need a lot of oil huh? Okay, so this one possible, okay, wait and see lah. So this two line 8.4 possible buy or add, 8.2 run So COVID drop okay, not bad lah, 4,008. This one is a Huatai, sorry already. So got a few more stuff to talk about lah. So some of our friends asked about Pestec, asked about the what's the development on the this one EV stock okay, EV stock, we take a quick look lah, Pestec. I think MPI doing well lah. I don't want to talk about MPI lah. MPI doing well. Pestec maybe have a drop, so maybe a lot of people curious Pestec. Okay, so Pestec already hit target 1.27 already Okay, our target 1.27 to 1.38. So it already hit the first target. Now come back down. Remember whenever when we buy chase momentum right. Let's say we chase a breakout right. Okay, the price already went to the first target. Okay, so you don't want to take profit. Then the price come back down. Okay, if the price come back down, let's say your target really 10%, it really went up 10%. So if it come back down to break even, means really the first target is already a target, means it cannot go any higher, then break even, sell it out. This one maybe you break even, sell it out. So this one, right, already hit target, you didn't take profit, come back to break even, maybe you want to sell it out already. Another strategy, 16% really from that day when we talk here, right, already went up 16%. Okay, so if we didn't take profit, it come back down, right, to break even. Normally, right, when it hit a target, after that it cannot go up anymore, it come down. Okay, it come down a little bit, still okay. Okay, above our break even point, still okay, can hold. But if we drop to our break even point, that is up to the buyers, up to you guys, okay, whether you want to cut or not. Okay, if market is very very good, okay, you think the sentiment is good, KLCI is strong going up, okay, your industry is going up, maybe can. But when the market is very weak, KLCI very weak, everything is very weak, better cut. So whenever hit a target already, the price come back down to break even, then you have to think about it already. Maybe want to cut, because normally a good stock, a strong stock, after you hit the target, right, first target, okay, like here, this one, after you hit the first target, right, okay, it shouldn't come back down to break even. This was the target that I aim actually. I re-aim here, the target was 1.27 between here to here. It really hit. Okay, so look at Kin. Kin not so good. I think Kin didn't hit the target. Okay, Kin, but Kin come back to break even already. Kin we talk about here, right? Now its price is slightly lower than break even. Break even we went in around here 4.4. Okay, so this one is 4.425, now this is today is 4.28, so there is a minor loss a 3% loss this one I think this one I'll cut first. RSI really dropped below 50. Okay, this one I will cut first. So maybe you want to take a look at MPI also just in case. KSM really talk MPI, others I think doing well only these two not doing well. MPI okay lah, holding above 46, still okay lah, slowly going up, still not, haven't dropped below 46. So target is 452 lah. Okay, so if you hit target, you didn't take profit, if you come back down to your break even price, maybe you want to out if market is not good lah, Okay, so that's it for today. So see you again tomorrow. Stay safe from COVID. Bye bye.